In this cake mapping tutorial, I'm going to show you a way to use a single display machine running macOS to output to two projectors, and also how to cake map using Qlab and MadMapper software. This is aimed at people who already understand the basics of cake mapping. If you need a primer, check out my tutorial for absolute beginners that also uses free software. Luma Bakery is your source for everything cake mapping, where you can watch cake mapping videos, learn how to cake map, and buy video content for your cake mapping projects. Qlab is a Q-based playback software that is used a lot in theatre and live events and handles all types of multimedia like audio, video, and lighting. Cues are actions that can be triggered either manually in a live environment or programmed ahead of time and executed when you press go. Qlab can be downloaded for free, however the workflow I've devised requires a multi-screen video output and Syphon output, which are only features of Qlab's Pro Video license type. This license can either be bought for a one-time payment or rented per day, which is a great option. I'm still using version 3 of Qlab. Version 4 is out, and I've only played with the demo version so far, but it looks almost exactly the same for our purposes. So we have Qlab handling our media playback, using it to control which videos play, in what order, how long to wait between videos, whether we want to loop back to the beginning, and so on. MadMapper will be handling the mapping side of things. We get Qlab to speak to MadMapper using Syphon, which works on your computer's graphics card to enable applications to share video in real time. As I mentioned before, Syphon only works on macOS. You can download a demo version of MadMapper for free, but it has certain limitations, such as being unable to save your scene and a watermark across its output. You can buy a perpetual license or again rent the software per day. The key to running multiple projectors from a single display machine is using a piece of hardware to add additional displays. I'll be using an external multi-display adapter called Dual Head to Go by Matrox to do this. In another context, this might be used to add a second monitor at someone's work desk, for example. Coders and artists often do this. But in our case, our two displays won't be monitors, they'll be output to projectors. Matrox also sells triple head to go if you're interested in using three projectors. We'll just be using two. Here's an overview of our setup. The dual head to go adapter comes with two cables that connect to the laptop or desktop computer via USB and mini display port or Thunderbolt port. The dual head-to-go adapter then connects via DVI output to the two projectors' HDMI input. If when you first plug in the dual head-to-go you see this, don't panic. I set up my display deliberately like this to show you how you can rectify it. Come down here into displays and in arrangement, turn off mirror displays and things should go back to normal. And now we can see our stretched dual display over here outputting from the projectors. Let's open Qlab and bring in some content. I'm going to use these videos here. I'll move this to the top because it's more a utility asset that will help us during the mapping phase. We want to stay organized, so if we come up here into queues, we can see the action to group, which has the hotkey command 0. I'll be using that from now on. We create a group and drop numbered UV into it and rename the group utilities. I'll copy and paste the numbered UV image because we'll want one to help us for the left projector and another for the right. As you can see, each of these videos has its own left and right content. I'll group these using command 0. When this queue list is set off, the queues will trigger depending on how they've been programmed to behave. Groups can be set up to behave a certain way by coming down here into its mode tab. It's already set up to do what I want, which is to land on the group, enter the group, and start the first child of the group, in this case, Fairy Cascade Left. Once Qlab starts playing Fairy Cascade Left, I also need it to be playing Fairy Cascade Right at exactly the same time, and I set that up by coming down here and changing left from Do Not Continue to Auto Continue. As for Fairy Cascade Right, I don't want the next queue to trigger, i.e. the group containing horse and carriage, until the fairy cascade has completed, so I set it to auto-follow, as in, the next queue will follow this one once it has finished. You might have noticed these little icons appeared as I set these continue behaviours. These are a quick way to replicate these auto-continues and auto-follows. You can set them by clicking and double-clicking in these areas. So I'll just set up these groups to behave in the same way to fairy cascade. Auto-continue, auto-follow, and so on. To keep things tidier, I'll select everything and go to Tools, renumber selected queues, and say Start at 1, Increment by 1, Renumber. Now you could introduce all sorts of queues in here. Transitions, pauses, loops, but I want to do something very simple and have these three videos loop until I hit the escape key and stop playback manually. I'll do that with a start cue, and I'll set 4 as its target. That's the first thing in my looped group. So my list will play through until it hits the start cue at 13, and then it will jump back to 4 and loop around like that again and again until it is manually stopped. Now we need to start assigning separate surfaces to our left and right content. If you come down here into the bottom right and click on this cog, you will be taken to workspace settings. In video, I'll delete these two surfaces to make a clean slate and create a new empty surface. I'll call it left. I'll make it 1920 by 1080, which is the resolution of my full HD projector. I'll assign it my stretched dual display, which is 3840, i.e. two lots of 1920 by 1080. I'll also assign it a Syphon stream. Then I duplicate this and call it right. Back in my main cue list, everything looks pretty broken, but that's because I deleted the surface they were all originally assigned to. Now in display and geometry, I assign them their respective surfaces, left for left and right for right. I mustn't forget to set behaviors for the numbered UV utility asset. Like before, I want left and right to play at the same time, so I want right to auto-continue from left. However, unlike the video content, I don't need to set any follow behavior because I want Qlab to stay on it indefinitely while I use it to help with mapping. I'll assign those left and right surfaces. Now I'll save. Then I'll trigger my numbered UVs to play in Qlab either by hitting the big go button or using the spacebar. Now opening up MadMapper, I can see my two Syphon streams left and right. And if I view my input as opposed to output up here, I can see my numbered UV. Incidentally, I could choose to view input and output at the same time, but it's clearer just looking at input for now. This next stage should be straightforward. If it's not obvious to you what I'm doing, I'd strongly recommend you watch my beginner's tutorial. Now I come to this tab with the projector to look at my output settings. Projector 1, its output destination is either screen 1 or screen 2, depending on which projector, left or right, you plugged into which DVI slot on the dual head to go. For me, it was slot 1, which is screen 1. I'd advise you turn off the visibility of all but one surface at a time, otherwise they stack on top of one another and it can get confusing. Under output, enter full screen mode, hotkey command U, and your left projector will start outputting content. Also under output, toggle on the cursor, which will be helpful. Now go through the process of mapping the 5 surfaces to the left side of the cake. Save your file. Now for the right side. Go to your applications and locate MadMapper. You can probably see what I've done, but I'll walk it back a bit. I've renamed the application that was originally called just MadMapper to MadMapper Left, and I've duplicated it and renamed it MadMapper Right. Now I have 2 copies of the application, one to handle each output. Start up the newly created MadMapper Right. Load your file you just saved over in MadMapper Left, and most of the work has already been done for you. Go to File, Save As, and call this file something like MadMapper Right. Now you just need to rename the surfaces, change the output destination of your projector to screen 2 instead of screen 1, and map these surfaces to the right-hand side of the cake. If I select all these surfaces and double-click the right Syphon stream, they will now all receive that input. We can see the little 5 tag transfer from left to right. Now if we go to Qlab and trigger our cue list, we're going to see our content mapped on the cake. The way we've set it up, your cue list will loop until you hit escape in Qlab, which stops the list. You've mapped a cake using 2 projectors with Qlab and MadMapper. If you like the fairy cascade, the horse and carriage, or the hearts video content, they're available to buy in the online shop at lumabakery.com. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to hit like and subscribe.